गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेल, सेफ इनसाइड योर होम्स। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद चैप्टर 5 इन सिविक्स, दैट इज सॉरी वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद चैप्टर 5 इन सिविक्स, दैट इज जुडिशियल। सो व्हाट आर अर्लियर वी हैव स्टडीड व्हाट इज जुडिशियरी, व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ जुडिशियरी एंड व्हाट इज इंडिपेंडेंट जुडिशियरी। सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी विद स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कोर्ट्स इन इंडिया। सो व्हाट आर द स्ट्रक्चर, व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कोर्ट्स? So the judicial system of India is stratified, that is, it is divided into various levels. At the top we have Supreme Court, followed by High Court, and then District Courts, and then the Lok Adalats, which are there at the Panchayat level or village level. So this is the structure: Supreme Court, High Court, District Court and Lok Adalats. Central level, state level, district level, village or Panchayat level. It is very much clear from the figure. You can understand, you can simply look at the picture and get an understanding of what are the different levels and what is the structure of courts. So now we will start with Supreme Court. So it is the highest judicial body, of course. Why? Because it is at the top. So it is the highest judicial body in India and it is there in New Delhi. It came into power on 28th January 1950, just 2 days after the constitution came into effect, that is 26th January 1950, that is our Republic Day. So the Chief Justice of India and 25 other judges will make up to the Supreme Court of India. So there are 25 other judges and one Chief Justice of India. The appointments are done directly by the President of India. So it has got the highest or the biggest responsibility. Next we have is High Court of India. So there are high courts in almost all the states and union territories. So the high courts, they work under the Supreme Court in the country. So these courts can decide on both civil and criminal cases. Most of the cases that are handled by the high courts of the country are passed on from the district or lower courts. So when a person is not satisfied with the district court, he will go to the High Court, and if it's not satisfied by High Court, he will again go to the Supreme Court. So the Calcutta High Court, which was established in 1862, it is the oldest court in India. Next we have is District Courts in India. So the District Courts in India, they take care of the judicial matters at the district level. These courts are headed by a judge. So one judge is there and they are headed by that. They are administratively and judicially controlled by the High Court of their states. There are many secondary courts which work under the district courts. So there are many other different courts which work under the district courts. Next we have is PIL, that is, we will first understand what is PIL actually. Litigation is the act or process of bringing or contesting a lawsuit. It is given in law terms. I will make it simpler for you. So what is litigation? Litigation is the act or it is the process of bringing or consenting a lawsuit. Whatever problem you have, you can write it on a paper and submit it to the court. That is public interest litigation. I repeat, PIL. It is the litigation that is filed in the court of the law for the protection of the public interest, say for example issues like pollution, terrorism or road safety or construction hazards, etc. Areas where PIL can be filed are violation of the basic human rights, content or conduct of government, policy or other basic fundamental rights. So these are the areas where PIL can be filed in the court. Now, who are the people who can actually file it? Any individual or organization can file a PIL in the High Court or on the Supreme Court. So it is not necessary that the person who is filing the case should have a direct interest in the case. The midday meal scheme that the children now receive in the government schools and government aided schools, that is because of PIL. Why? Because some people had filed a PIL, that is public interest litigation, that midday meal scheme should be introduced and children should be given food. Poor children should be given the food in the school, and that is why it is now happening. So for the common person, access to the courts is access to the justice. Now we will conclude, that is, judiciary has played a crucial role in democratic India, serving as a check on the powers of the executive and the legislature as well in protecting the fundamental rights of the citizens. It means that there is a very important role of judiciary which it has to follow apart from the executive and the legislature which are already there. So that was it for today. I hope you have understood it clearly. Thank you and have a nice day.